weei.com/save for details. Service is not available in all areas.
Time now for EEI Late Night with KJ.
The AFC, I think, is kind of open. You have two games against the Buffalo Bills. The team's 3-5. It's headed in the right direction. It is not, you know, it's going through its rebuild. Even now, even if it makes the playoffs this year, it is still a rebuilding team. It just doesn't bottom out like other rebuilding teams do because of who the head coach is. But I would not sell off anybody. I don't think that they're in a position where they need to do that. So you would be selling off pieces that aren't really saving you money. And you'd be getting back future returns when you built a core. You bought it this year, but you built it. So I would not be a seller.
What? Late Night, WEEI with KJ. That's Tommy Curran on Gretchen Keefe saying the Patriots should be buyers at the deadline because they're a playoff contender? Tonight, thank you, Justin Herr, for being here and producer extraordinaire. The music bumpers tonight will celebrate some of the most well-known horror songs in celebration of Halloween this weekend. As Ghetto Boys famously said, this year Halloween fell on a weekend. The Patriots are the best non-thrilling team in the NFL. Look, put the 50 burger out of your head. Tell your story. About a year ago, I'm having lunch with the former traffic reporter on a morning show I used to do in Boston, right here in the city. During the lunch, she proceeded to tell me that the morning show that I was doing at that time was the best, worst morning show she's ever heard. Now, I won't get into specifics, but you can deduce whom she may have been referring to because I was the one at the lunch, not the other people from the show. I get why she said that. See, because it was really good while it was bad. This is where the Patriots are right now. They're really good, bad. Now remember, two of the wins are against the Jets, one against Houston. Now the Houston one was closer to what a real feeling was. Like, what are you doing? It's Houston. The Jets come to town. Even Richard Seymour said, hey, look, I wanted to get retired into the Ring of Honor for our homecoming game against the Jets. That's what it was. This is different this weekend. The Patriots are the best non-thrilling team in football. The best. Mac Jones is hot. He's on the lips of many. I happened to be on BetQL's Sunday spread last week on Twitch and across the BetQL radio network, where I was asked, hey, people want to know, when are you going to take the training wheels off of Mac Jones? And my response was, you know, if you have to talk about training wheels in a league of 10 speeds and mountain bikes, maybe the bike's not big enough yet. So enjoy the best that you've seen so far against the Jets and Houston. Those are the three wins. The best non-thrilling team in the NFL are the Patriots. Like my best worst morning show, we got some good shots in, right? Did well with women. They love the show. That is, if they could hear it inside of a brick wall or behind a large tree. But other than that, the best worst thing kind of worked. And let's just face it, it's working for the fan base. Everybody's ready to give Mac a pass through this entire year. Despite this may be the worst winning percentage year since 2001. This entire century. But again, this best, worst version of the Patriots isn't as bad as it may finish. Last season, which was the worst this century, was a 7-9 team. 428 winning percentage. So, if last year was 7-9 and you do the math at this point, what would the Patriots' record be if you times 17 games and its current percentage, winning percentage, which is 435? You get 7 games. It's worse. You will go 7-10 at this realm when going 7-9 last year. Albert Breer, a Monday morning quarterback, says there might be some issues with leadership with this team.
We saw some of the younger players and the newer players take ownership. There was a real question, I think, over the last few weeks internally in that organization about leadership and about whether or not older guys like Devin McCourty and Dante Hightower and Kyle Van Noy were getting through to the locker room. And I know that there were some newcomers who came into this place and sort of said to themselves, this isn't what I expected. This isn't what I thought the Patriots were going to be. And so seeing some young guys and seeing some new guys and seeing some guys who maybe weren't around for the championships take charge, guys like Mac Jones and Jonnu Smith and Damian Harris, I think was a very significant thing. So that's the biggest thing I think to take away for today. You know, you go out and you take a bad opponent and you bury them the way that they did. But I think the fact that some of those younger guys and some of the newer guys who weren't here for championships took lead roles was pretty significant.
The best non-thrilling team in the NFL. Hang on to Mac Jones. All those millions spent in the offseason, that's not even really the story anymore. It's not. I mean, you're literally starting to look at the schedule. You say, hey, how does this team get four more wins? They got to try and, I mean, obviously they could go for it in San Diego. I mean, in Los Angeles. But my goodness, Justin Herbert's a year older. And have you seen Mike Williams? 617-779-7937 or the text line 37937. It's KJ Late Night here on WEEI. Coming up, Bet City, to salute those who just had horrible bets last week. That's at 1040. And then Parlez-Vous, where Justin, am I lying when I tell people that we found a $100 parlay that could make them a millionaire?
We absolutely did do that.
We found that. That's at 1045. The Patriots are not in that parlay.
And that might be a good thing.
Well, that's pretty much it. Well, you never know. You never know, but it's not in this one. They're not going to win you millions of dollars this week. So on Marloni and Fourier, which they do a wonderful job making Mac Jones comfortable, answering questions. He is a rookie. This is a high-profile situation. A lot of eyes are on it. And they wondered about where the Patriots sit in the AFC and how does that affect Mac Jones. Give me that break.
2-4 start wasn't what you're looking for. You're now 3-4. But do you ever just at a moment sit back and just sort of look at the rest of the AFC? It's not like, 5-2, 3-4, 4-3. It just seems like everybody's right there. So as much as you didn't get that good start that maybe you wanted, do you ever just look around and say, okay, we're okay?
Yeah, I think just focusing on what we can control and not looking at results is hard. And I think we all agree that some of the games could have gone a different way and all that, but it's part of the game. And like I said earlier, we just got to, score more points than the other team. It's really that simple. And if we continue to do that, then good things will happen. But I think it's more process and doing things the right way throughout the week and continuing to come together and communicate in meetings and on the field and just talking things out to where we feel even more comfortable every week.
Boy, I should have Lou Maloney be a babysitter for my family. What AFC is he watching? Still in it? Have you seen the AFC North? Have you seen the AFC West? Have you seen the best, least exciting team in the Patriots? Second in the AFC East? That's not hard to do, though. But, some were like, hey, Mac Jones still could be Rookie of the Year. Screech! Vegas now has Jamar Chase as favorite to win Rookie of the Year. Well, we bought the Mac Jones jerseys, number two. That's fallen to number seven. Look, Mac is starting to cook. That's what people wanted, right? Josh McDaniels, take the training wheels off. I mean, last week, after seeing, about 30 trick plays, it's like, we get it. It's like going for fourth down on Madden before they put the intelligence in there and saying, the game is not as stupid as you think. You're not going to get away with it this week. Not with the Chargers. But Mac is starting to cook as the season is slowly burning. And remember, while anybody could beat anybody on any given Sunday, how many of those Sundays are left? Are you saying to yourself, okay, Carolina, Atlanta, I think we got Miami again. It's like playing that card game where you're just like trying to squeeze that last card out of your hand when you think about it. Indy got better quick. Tennessee is much better than people expected. The Browns are holding steady their ship despite some pretty bad injuries. This is a game. I've been one of those proponents, and I've said this forever. There's no such thing as a moral victory. If there was, there'd be a column for it. Well, in soccer, it's called a draw, right? There are no draws in football. Well, there is technically in football, but even the players don't even know how you get to a draw in football. They're like, we keep playing. I thought it was sudden death. You know, like not sudden and hurt. So when it comes to this Chargers game this weekend, where, yeah, the Saints game was very important, this one is really, really important on the road against the tough team who's not good against the run, and that could help the Patriots unless Josh McDaniels has visions of dancing plums in his head like he did last week with the 50 burgers. The Chargers are only behind Buffalo in terms of giving up passing yards. So, homie doesn't play that. But yet there's still that belief. I still believe. It's like that commercial my kid loves where they have the choice to either jump in the running car or go hide behind the chainsaws. Look, Danny Woodhead thinks that he wouldn't be surprised if the Patriots make the playoffs.
New England's almost two plays from being 4-2. Like, everyone wants to, I don't want to say just say, oh, you know what, they're done, yada, yada, yada. I wouldn't be shocked if they win a bunch of games and maybe make the playoffs. I'm not saying they're going to, but like, you guys, they're good. They're a good football team.
They were one play away from beating the Dolphins early. They fumbled. The game was over. They were just trying to run the clock.
Yes.
So that's the tough
could,
one.
Could have beat the Bucs.
Could have beat the Bucs. Went to overtime with the Cowboys, you know?
That's in the Bucs and the Cowboys are a good football team.
Yeah.
Obviously, the Bucs are the Bucs. But say, but like, could be 4-2 very easily.
The best, worst morning show that I used to have is starting to sound a lot like, hey, the season is still young. True story. There's this guy who lived in this little town called Seagirt near me where I grew up in New Jersey. I'm not ashamed to admit that I grew up in New Jersey. It's better than growing up in New York. And this guy who lived in Seagirt, that 10 minutes from my house, he used to say, your record says who you are. This guy in Seagirt is also the guy who made the comment, if you want to cook the dinner, they ought to let you shop for some of the groceries. He was talking about a childhood friend of mine that I went to high school with, a kid named Christian. You might have heard of that story. The Patriots are 3-4. 2 wins against the Jets. And if you didn't have that, if you thought the natives were mad about the Baltimore series with the Red Sox at the beginning of the season, jeez. And Houston, who seems like every week they can create some type of debauchery that is unbelievable. And the Pats let that game come to some type of competition. Yes, that live in Seagirt. His name's Bill Parcells. If you're trying to figure out, like, Seagirt, where's Seagirt? I'm looking on a map. And Bill Belichick knows it too. I mean, after all, what was the Pats' record after 8 games last season? Come here. It was 3-5. But again, this is the best, most non-exciting, worst team in the NFL. It's truly amazing. Because if this was last year, oh wait, I remember what it sounded like last year. A bunch of people pretty much calling for the Scarlet Letter chick to be burned at the stake. But you don't hear this year. With more weapons. With a better quarterback. a loss in Los Angeles to the Chargers puts them at 3-5, the same spot they were last year. And remember, with the 17th game this year, if, you know, the Patriots win 7 games again, hey, it was just, no, it's actually percentage-wise worse than last year. But it doesn't feel that way. So like Danny Woodhead was saying, look, the Patriots could go on a run. It has to start Sunday. It's got to be a thriller. Like, literally, these ghosts have to come out of the ground, like in the video, and start dancing for their wins. Bob Kraft paid hundreds of millions of dollars. And if you believe anything, that comes right out of Seth Wickersham's mouth. The story out this week that, yeah, the Patriots were trying to get Jimmy G before the draft, what now makes you say, oh, is Mac here because Bob says, I'm not going to pay like Tom money for a broken down guy or your guy. But again, like I said, take it with a grain of salt. Everybody's not necessarily on the Seth Wickersham, boat, if you will, with what he has to say about the Patriots. And that's a fair assessment. Don't win against the Chargers. The team is just as bad as last year. It's just actual fact. And the schedule, you don't even have a bye week into the 13th week. Still haven't played Buffalo. You got one more of those Miami games. You got any more of those Jets games we could play? No, those are gone already. It's like the women who used to say to you, you can't have your cake and eat it too. I'm talking about the team feels good and you have all this hope on the horizon and the team is bad. But of course, thanks to 3D printing, you can now print your own cake and eat said cake that you just printed. But that doesn't work in football. Do records really matter now when it comes to the sports fan? Isn't it kind of like where we are in just this cultural society now where if it feels good, despite having a losing record, it feels good. It's right. Even though the team is just as bad as last year. It's truly amazing. 617-779-7937 or text line 37937. It's KJ on WEEI Late Night. Here's where I can understand the patience of the fan base. This is where I can understand it. You do see Mac putting in the work, therefore, by law of nature, attraction, whatever you want to call it, he is going to get good return. I just don't believe it's going to be this year in terms of a record, but you do see the work being put in. The ball's getting out quicker. He's making headier decisions. It does feel good to see the ball go up in the air, out of the screen, and come down in a receiver's hands. We haven't seen that in a couple of years, let's be honest. And so I commend the work that Mac is putting in. Just like my best, worst morning show. I mean, I did get something out of it. So maybe let's not even worry about whether Mac is going to be Rookie of the Year. Would you really want your Rookie of the Year to have the worst winning percentage this century? And for those who don't know how almanacs work or time works, January 1st, 2001 is the beginning of the 21st century. 2000 is still in the 20th century.
Remember that?
You remember that, Justin, right?
I do remember that, yeah.
Yeah, just because, you know, like I said, we're kind of in this environment. I was just telling my wife tonight, we may start to see game shows where people say, well, technically that's not wrong, even though they got the buzzer. I'm sorry, that's incorrect. Well, technically it's not. Why not? Because I don't feel like it's wrong. As I said, that kind of big guy that lived in Seagirt about 10 minutes from where I grew up said, your record is what your record is. It says who you are. This is a 3-4 team that hundreds of millions of dollars was spent on. Like, nobody has their tiki torches from last year? I mean, I know there's a supply chain issue, but damn, get mad like you did last year. That's all I'm saying. Let's trend.
The Greg Hill Show, weekdays 6 to 10. Now here's what's trending on WEEI.